I promised I'd be back. Don't worry. I have things under control. For now. I see you've been using the powers the tadpole gives you. Good. But things haven't gone as you expected. You thought Nettie might be able to help you in the Druid's Grove. But all she did was reaffirm the danger. You're desperate to be rid of it. Understandable. But you're looking for solutions in the wrong places. Your parasite is unusual. It is wrapped in magic that prevents its removal. Until the source of the tadpole's magic is destroyed, any attempt to remove it will kill you. The parasites are merely a symptom of a greater sickness in Faerun. I am not sure yet. To find the answers, we must first find the source. These parasites are more than illithid spawn. They are vessels for control. The infected hear the voice of the Absolute and believe it to be a god. That is how the cult of the Absolute is spreading. The highest of their rank, the True Souls, carry a tadpole just like yours. It is how they receive their orders. It is what makes them obey. When the order to transform is given, it will not be a matter of days. They will be Mind Flayers in an instant. Were it not for my protection, so would you. It's complicated, but I'm an adventurer, just like you. Just like you, I was infected with a Mind Flayer parasite. Just like you, I seek to be free of it. I've been trying to escape from this evil for a long time. Once, I almost succeeded. Now, through you, I've been given a new chance. You can go where I cannot, and I can protect you from that evil. If we work together, we may turn this around. Hells, they need me. I have to go. The power I used to protect you, I stole it from someone. They want it back. I will hold them off for as long as I can, but sooner or later I will be worn down. You must discover the source of the magic that controls the parasites before that happens. Follow the cultists' trail. They will lead you to their masters. Use the powers your parasite gives you to convince them you are one of them. And when you find the source of their magic, destroy it. Go. Our freedom depends on it.
Careful, Azel. It's dark around here. Would be a terrible shame to lose you forever.
Yes. Do keep your wits, Shadowheart. Should the dagger suddenly slice your neck, we may never know who's to blame.
Thank you. swift as my feet can carry me. These boots have seen everything.
Nice.
No rest for the wicked, I see.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have.
Thank you.
everywhere. Who would dig these? And why here?
Cracked like an egg. Must have fallen quite some height.
I think I found something. Some of these mushrooms are illusions. Look at that.
Not from someone's campfire either. Best be careful.
Farther can I go?
What's next? On I go.
Let me work my magic. May it please, Mistra.
Assume nothing. Efficient path.
least things have stayed interesting. Never wanted the easy path.
From Waterdeep. Yes.
Quickly then.
Let's get going. Breathe deep and move. Wish I had a bag of holding.
My faith will guide me. Let's try this way.
Ahead.
Another dream. Another order from that dubious visitor. It announced that we will find the answers we seek in the absolute cultist's lair, and offered another generous gift. A persuasive creature. It tempts us with power, expresses its admiration, its adoration. Avert your eyes whenever it appears, and do not avail yourself of this new power, no matter how alluring. You've no idea what damage it could do to us, how far into illithid madness it could drag us. Yes, the one truth that fell out of its cankered lips. There will come a battle. But it will be won with swords, not mind games born of brainworms. It is a certainty, I had assumed our parasites served a Geish elder, but I believe they serve a greater master still. A question that burns in my belly day and night. Elders and collectives abide by their own tenets. It would require a powerful creed to unite them. And now this voice, this creed, finds our own ears. If it reaches this plane, it may reach others. I have a confession. I was too hasty to judge you. I thought you witless, gutless, unimpressively bland. Now, well, you've earned my respect and more still. You've proven your wits. You are efficient and dominant, in and out of battle. You've proven your courage. I swear you would tear the horns off one dragon to plunge into another. And you're hardly bland. Your scent alone is enough to make my neck sweat and my hairs stand on end. Isn't it obvious? I want to taste you. Perhaps tonight, perhaps later, but I want it all the same. Do you? Yes.
Why not, eh?
Perhaps one night soon, I will come to your bunk and take what is mine. Until that night comes, I shall keep enjoying your scent.
Is his sanctum, private place for research and respite. But as this wizard's not home, I say we take a peek.
Welcome, rest.
That's what I go for. It's also seeking for that number.
Bet I can crack that open.
Fucking kidding me. This is a fucking joke.
Thank you. doesn't look broken. Enough time wasted. Battle awaits.
Well, yeah, sure.
Come to sate you and be sated. I lead, you follow. So you think. Let's see if you're right.
Gith train relentlessly. We know our bodies inside and out. Let me show you. Close your eyes and submit.
A pause. Across your neck.
Open. Taste.
You awake in pain. Your back, your hands, even your tongue ache.
It's time to rise. Dawn is upon us. You do look peaked. Very well. Take your moment. Time for pleasure has passed. I might take more later, should my whims so carry me. Up now. The sun soon rises.
Every breath, every blink proves exhausting. A long day awaits you.
Well, that was something.
dog wags his tail, a small bag clenched between his teeth. He gives in and surrenders his find to you. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
Someone sneaking up on us.
What's this? Got ourselves an infiltrator. You move pretty quietly. Not quietly enough for my liking, though. Noise gets you eaten down here. Reckon I'll hush you before something hungry comes along.
His gnarled fist grips an axe.
There we go, decent roll.
Fine. I'll let you live. But spoil my hunt, and you're dead. Told you, hunting. Slave ran away, took Sergeant Thryn's boots. Gotta kill the slave and fetch back the leather. Or the bosses in Moonrise will have Thryn's hide. Sergeant told me to. Besides, we're talking about a slave. Help? You don't even know what you'd be up against. Slave's got herself some protection. Hiding up there in a myconid circle. Can't get past those rot flowers. They get in your head, make you see things. Half my squad jumped off a cliff, laughing. I'll wait here. She'll make a run for it eventually. Then I'll get her. You're either brave or stupid to be worried about your purse in these parts. Get those boots. Then we can talk rewards. Maybe you'll even be allowed into the Absolute's ranks. Deep Gnome Slave. They all look the same. But this one's got fancy boots. She's with the rest of our expedition across the lake. Special mission for the Absolute. Get the leather. I ain't wasting more words on you until it's done.
This dark.
A vessel wobbles on the lake's murky waters.
What are you doing on Gek's raft? Where's Gek? Who are you? Huh. How desperate is the cur to make an ally of a topsider?
I will tell you what the sergeant told Gek. Until you have the boots, you will not cross.
Come back empty-handed again, and you're feeding the fishes.
You push once more into darkness.
Saw you making off with our boat. You should have stayed away, sun scum.
Be conquered.
I will split your corpse and roast to pieces.
Try something else.
Yeah.
take your humor.
Die, so your carcass can rise. Silence.
Nightmare.
Tail. Through the ocular lens.
I'll go from here. Another step forward.
Kaiko Tei!
Thank you.
One day, I'll catch up.
Why the fuck went that fucker die?
May the gods take you first.
Thank you. haste.
One can't always be a gentleman.
Support incoming. On my way. Awaits.
Thank you.
time to press ahead.
Fucking hell, man. That was ridiculous. Hey, how's it going? I'm not too bad, thanks for asking.
Rock under your feet juts upwards, forming a perfectly engraved tombstone with a small epitaph. In memory of Myrna, a shining light in this dark world, may you forever gaze upon the lake you love to play in. As you dig, you slowly expose the skeletal remains of a large dog wearing a chunky leather collar.
Strange collar. It's got runes all over it. I wonder what they say.
I'm not too sure what you mean. Do you mean like just my favourite game or?
Victory awaits.
That's a Sousa tree. These things drain away one's magic.
On the move.
Thank you.
been a long day. I need to rest soon.
Need anything else? Of course. But please, remember, you're not the only one in need. Sylvanas be with you.
For battle.
Never a dull moment.
Speak of an adamantine forge hidden deep below.
Seems it's guarded by a protector of some sort. Something weak to this hot hammer.
Thank you.
I had another dream. Which, I suppose, means you did as well. Whoever's reaching out to us truly does seem opposed to the Absolute, but wants us to embrace the tadpole. Venture right into the heart of the cult. Perhaps we truly have a secret protector. Or we're walking into a trap.
I had another visit from that dream figure. I take it you did too. It claims that if we infiltrate the heart of the cult that's giving out these parasites, we'll find the answers we're looking for. It gave me another gift, too. Just like it did the first time it appeared. Rather generous, if you ask me. And while we're at it, we can see how many more of these little worms we can harvest. Now, was there anything else?
Curious. I took of you completely. Yet your body seems no more worse for wear. Perhaps I might find use for it again. If you must know, Vlakith requires everything of her children. I can't count how many bruises I've inflicted. Can't measure how much blood I've drawn in the Undying Queen's name. I know only blood red and death black. My mind is silver, and my body steel. I am what I must be, say what I must be. To survive every beast I face and every wound I bear. I'll consider it if I am in need of relief. Until then, I'll enjoy watching you squirm from the anticipation of it.
Dreaming of our enigmatic visitor again. She told me our purpose was to take on this cult of the Absolute, to infiltrate its ranks and bring it down from the inside. She even offered me greater powers, the result of some manipulation of the tadpole's psionic abilities. Given the magnitude of what we're up against, I see no harm in considering the benefit this offer might afford us. Could be the only way to reach this source in one piece. Existential evils go, the Absolute certainly seems an adversary worth holding in its tracks. Any opportunities for us to indulge our tadpole's capabilities are hardly on the same scale. Trifles, when one considers the bigger picture.